event lab for this week was interesting.
It was.
Not particularly, fascinating or anything, but it was somewhat interesting. I like that little one, like, literally what it said, like, you got a handbrake turn on that 180. Yeah, you do. You really do.
Yeah, but honestly, every single time, I think it's because I had the stock version of that car, but when I did a handbrake turn, I bogged so bad.
I think I was in the stock version too, but I seem fine. I just handbrake downshift. It seems fine.
Yeah, it's permanent rain instead of ongoing weather.
Okay, my brakes suck. I had to go around that rock.
Yeah, I saw that.
Should just handbrake that.
Goodbye. Ooh, I just looked in back. Ouch.
The fucking jump screwed me up.
You'll catch up soon enough. You have all-wheel drive and an RB2060 ETT. Meanwhile, here I am with an inline 4 that's supercharged.
Yeah, but also a car that weighs as much as a soapbox racer. Heavy.
I remember you like this part of the course where I'm at right now. Especially in A class.
Liking it as much in B class.
Is it because of the car you have?
The car is like unwieldy on jumps. I do not like it. It's so unwieldy. Like even on like a flat jump, right, or like a flat bounce. For some reason, even though the front has more weight, the front will actually go up. and it's I can't see shit.
Oh yeah, because you're running first person, that's right.
My pulse is better on the shorter rally courses. Idea for another B-class rally car, actually.
What is it?
The R31 Skyline.
Oh, that blocky one.
Yeah, it looks the part.
Yeah, I can agree with that.
And it's rear-wheel drive, so I'm actually going to try to keep it that way.
I mean, this is rear-wheel drive, my MR2.
Yeah, so is my fucking Trans Am, and that thing sucks. Actually, I think I retuned it, but I haven't taken it out in a while. This thing's rebound stiffness is too high.
Oh, that's probably why it sucks into jumps.
Yeah, no, I can tell because, like, it compresses a lot and then all of a sudden just boing, right back up.
Oh, yeah, the MR2 was guilty of doing that, too. That's why I had to your help in retuning it.
Yeah, just, like, basically divide by half again.
I mean, I already did the divide by half and half again, so essentially dividing by four. But I had to do some extra softening.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we did, like, another divide by half, probably.
Oh god, I left you behind, holy shit.
I missed another checkpoint, but I mean,
You missed two checkpoints? And you're that close?
I missed one.
Oh, okay.
I missed one. Well, it wasn't a missed checkpoint, as in, like, the game gave me the thing. Like, I went just outside of it, and I just did a loop around to get it.
Okay, that would explain why you're so close then.
Yeah. Car's good, but
it just doesn't like the course.
It doesn't like bumps, man. It's terrifying. The Quattro was fun. This is terrifying. Because the Quattro, you have control. This you don't. And the Quattro, it's all you. In this, it's all the car.
I do like how many areas I can initiate drifts. Even if it started normally, I extend it through e-brake. But this course in S1 was even more bonkers.
I still had more control than this.
Oh, I believe it.
The line was beautiful.
The R34, yeah.
That, it was perfect. But this? This car scares me. Terrible weight distribution. The rebound's too stiff. Oh god. I can see you for the first time in a while.
Hello, back there.
Oh fuck.
Spoke too soon.
Thank you. that will, if you manage to reel it in, it will podium, but oh my god, it is fucking terrifying to drive. I might maybe, like, change this thing around, make it more user-friendly. I'll see if I can keep the RB swap, because I like it, but...
I tried to do a fancy drift, but biffed it.
I'm amazed that I've made several mistakes and I'm still up here. That's how good this car is.
I tried to do a fancy drift and I failed.
I know, but even without that, like, I still, like, the gap wasn't that big.
No, it wasn't. Now the challenge is to play keep away.
Three. No.
Into the rocks you go.
I'm good. I went over them.
You were approaching me, like, with intent.
If I didn't lift at the end, like right before the jump, I would have passed you, but then I would have also flown into God knows where. And so... that's what, like, over 300 horsepower is doing.
Oh god!
Whoa! Whoa! Oh man! That looked almost as bad as my wreck earlier!
Yeah, the back bumper clipped the rock and I just went end for end. I would have won that for sure, though. Actually, if
11 flat.
Oh, nice.
Three mistakes.
Honestly, if neither one of us made mistakes, me with the drift under, and then that. 11. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, under 11, easy.
Yeah. Actually, I think when I did this solo, it was like 10 minutes and 45 seconds, something like that.